Hello student, welcome back. In the last class, we have discussed various history of microprocessor evolutions. In this section, we will discuss the architecture of 8088 or 8086. In the exam, if they ask 8088 and 8086, both architectures are same. So here you can see 8088 or 8086 contains, you can write only all the whatever points I can explain with this diagram. Diagram is required with this points, step by step, points by point, you can write. So, this one, 8086 contains two sections. One is called as a bus interface unit, second one is called as execution unit. So, bus interface unit fetch the instruction from the memory. For example, if I say here, let me use FEN. So microprocessor is connected to memory. Suppose if you think this is the memory, what memory will store programs. Programs means instruction and data. Bus interface unit will fetch the instruction from the memory and store the instruction in the queue. You may ask, what is the size of this queue? In 8086, the queue is only 6 bytes. That means it can store only 6 bytes of instruction. Then, address is generated by address generation and control signal for fetching the instruction from memory. These instructions, stored instructions, are once again taken by our execution unit. So, there are two types of unit. One is execution unit, second one is bus interface unit. Execution unit will take the instruction and it will execute with the help of ALU. What do you mean by ALU? Arithmetic and logical unit. Fine. Now, first we will see what is there in execution unit. Execution unit contains general purpose registers. These are called as general purpose registers. These are called as special purpose registers. So you may ask, what do you mean by general purpose register? General purpose register, the name itself indicates it can be used for any type of arithmetic and logical operations. So it is a 16-bit registers. So normally it is called as AX. It is divided into 8-bit and 8-bit. So A means accumulator. Accumulator high and accumulator low. Both makes AX. AX is equal to AH and AL. Similarly, BX, base registers. BH, B high and base high and base low. C means counter registers. Counter high and counter low. This is called as CX. D means data registers, DX. So these registers are called as general purpose registers. Irrespective of general purpose, you can use this as a specific purpose also. In the program, you will come to know when you can use this. For example, CX register sometimes you use as a counter registers for counting purpose. Other than that, we have something called as base pointer, stack pointer, pointer registers, which will point to the memory normally. And source index and destination index for indexing, which is very useful in string operations. So these are the information about the registers. So from register, so these register will store data. And instructions, and from this, operands moves to ALU. ALU performs arithmetic and logical operation on the operands. The output of the ALU is indicated by flag register. The status of the output of the ALU. For example, if the ALU performs 6 minus 6, then result is 0. This 0 is indicated by one of the flag bit in the flag register that is called as zero flag. So this is the operation or this is the operation of execution unit. Other than that, we have something called as here. Once again, let me clear this one. Here you can see we have segment registers. What is the use of segment registers? What do you mean by segment? Segment is, I said microprocessor is connected to memory. our memory is divided into normally blocks. For easy access, it is divided into blocks. So in 8086, normally we can find four blocks. One is called as code segment, other one is called as data segment, third one is called as stack segment, fourth one is called as extra segment. All these are called as various memory blocks. The size of each block is 64 KB. Please remember, 64 KB. So you can have 4 CS block, 4 DS block, 4 SS block, 4 ES block, because 64 into 16 is equal to 1 MB. It comes 1 MB. That's why you can have 4 CS block, 4 DS block, 4 SS blocks and 4 ES. Now, this will, suppose CS block is used for storing code, DS block is used for storing data, and SS is used for stack operations, and ES, that is extra segment. Extra segment is used for when the data segment is not sufficient, data segment is full, then you can, that time you can use extra segment to store additional data. So each segment will start at particular memory locations. So all these memory locations, starting address of this memory location is stored in the segment register. Please remember, this is segment register. This is segment. Segment is different. Segment register is different. The starting address of the segment register is stored in segment register. So now starting address of the code segment is stored in code segment register. Starting address of the data segment is stored in data segment register. Starting address of the stack segment is stored in stack segment register. Starting address of the extra segment is stored in extra segment registers. So that is the use of this one, segment register. Now you can ask me why we have to store. We have to tell the microprocessor where the code segment starts, where the data segment starts, where the stack segment starts. This is to tell the microprocessor that where the segment starts. That's why the starting address is copied. This is done by the software itself. Don't worry. Then next one is we have instruction pointer. Instruction pointer indicates the address of the next instruction to be executed. So my dear students, in the exam, very very important question, 8088, 8086 architecture, you have to explain this much. So this is the architecture of 8088 and 8086.